Muskies love weather like this. Huskies love boulders. They hate cinnamon.
I'm Bob White. I'm a fishing guide, an artist, and an author. And we're here in northern, well, middle Minnesota, Midwest, central Minnesota, fishing for muskie, having a good time with a lot of good friends.
I'm Kip Feith with Wildwood Float Trips, and I am a smallmouth and muskie guide in northern Minnesota.
My name is Dan Boggs. I'm with Blackwater Fly Fishing, based out of Stevens Point, Wisconsin.
Muskie is a large predator, alpha predator here in the North Woods. It is the king of the rivers, because I fish rivers primarily, and it is the alpha predator. So it is the freshwater version of a permit, probably.
Fishing for muskie is sort of like, it's almost like a medieval quest. It's something that you really, you hope it happens, you prepare for it, but you're not surprised when you're lost and it doesn't happen. I think that's the magic of it, is that it's one of those things like permit fishing where you're good, you're on your game, you're in the right place, you're confident in your fly, and it'll either all come together or it won't. And you just got to stay focused for that second when it comes together and be ready for it.
Most important thing about a musky fly is that you have confidence when you're throwing it. You want it to fish well, as well. When you're fishing it, you want it to kick. The biggest thing I try to tie it is so you get a kick. So you want that fly to pull through the water, and then on the pause, it'll kick to the side, or it'll kick down, or it'll kick up, or it'll kick left. I always say it's like a cat presenting when it kicks, because that's the way muskies eat, is sideways, generally. I say generally because nobody for sure knows how they always eat. But it gives them that nice look, gives them a pretty easy target. It's kind of low-hanging fruit for them as it comes through.
Up at dawn, just to be out on the water. Weatherman said hot and getting hotter, but he didn't say nothing about it. Raining like hell.
We're in central Minnesota on the Mississippi River, and we're floating approximately 30 miles of the upper Mississippi, which has been placed on catch and release only, so it's growing into quite a trophy fishery here in Minnesota.
You're fishing for the top predator in the river. There's not a lot they're scared of in the river. The best way to describe it is you're fishing for grizzlies. So you try to work your fly in such a manner as to kind of initiate that easy meal, low-hanging fruit, or that, you know, flight technique. If you were to come across the grizzly, the worst thing you can do is run from it, and that's what we're trying to do with our flies, get them to eat.
Musky fishing is a lot of time on the water, trying to stay focused and on top of your game for those few seconds when everything comes together and you've got a fish blowing up on your fly, or you've got an eat, or you look down and there's a 4-foot fish, right under the boat looking at your fly.
The skill factor comes into it for how often you can keep your meat wet, keep your fly in the water, keep it moving. That's the number one factor, is your fly in the water where muskies are at. And the skill also comes into it, making sure you got great knots, sharp hooks, and then most importantly, you know how to strip set. You gotta move that fly 4 feet. There's no rod sets with these fish.
What is a muskie? A muskie is magic. I don't know that they fight particularly hard. I think a muskie is one of those reminders of how crazy people are, and we all want what we can't have. And muskie are really good at not giving you what you want. They'll show themselves, they'll blow up on a fly, they'll follow a fly to the boat, but they're tough. They're tough to hook up with, and it's all about that. It's all about the eat. It's all about the moment when they're on the fly and they're lit up, coiled up, ready to strike, and they either do or they don't. And when it's all done, you realize you haven't been breathing for about a minute.
Baby brother about to run me out of my mind. Say, can I go fishing with you? I took him on down to the fishing hole. Now, what do you think?
So they're under the truck making whoopee, and And their buddy Sven pulls up in the truck. He says, "Holy Lena, what the f*** you doing down there?" And Holy says, "Well, we're checking the transmission. Can't you see nothing?" He says, "Well, while you're at it, check your brakes. Your truck won't drive the hill."